There are so many things that I would do differently if I was to go back in time and really teach myself the right things to do when it comes to transitioning from working for someone else to working for myself. So today I'm going to share my mistakes. What is the thing that I wish I knew so that you don't need to make these mistakes and you would have a much more efficient plan in being self-employed. Escape the 9-to-5 and create your path to freedom. If you're new here, I'm Lydia Lee, the freedom instigator at Screw the Cubicle, and my big passion and deep interest is to serve people like you who are professionals, who want to do meaningful work in the world, but they're not quite sure how to get started. So a lot of what I talk about here in this channel is how to be self-employed, how to build meaningful work and build a career you can be proud of, and most importantly, how to be you and utilize your personality, your interests, the way that you impact into a focus of doing good in the world while being able to make a good living as well doing it. So if you enjoyed this video and you've been following me, please share. I'm trying to build out this channel in a lot of ways to make sure that there are people that need to be here, right? It doesn't have to be big numbers. And if you're watching, you're very likely someone that's been here for quite a while. You might know someone that would really benefit from being in this channel. So please share this video with them, share this channel with them, and hopefully I'll benefit them and we'll be able to build a bigger community here in my YouTube channel. And if you haven't done so yet, don't forget to hit subscribe and that little bell icon button to be notified for every video that I produce here so that you'll be the first to know when a new piece of content comes live. Okay, mistake number one and the lesson I learned from making this mistake. Mistake number one is not taking the time to really explore the skills that I had that was actually useful and meaningful for me to create work around. Now, of course, this is now what I teach people, you know, at Screw the Cubicle, and it's become my primary thing that I do here, right? Helping people figure out what business to start, helping people figure out the work that they should be doing before they start spending time and money doing it. But I sure as hell did not do that when I first started. What I did was, and you know, now I'm going to say I'm still grateful for that I did it, and it got me out of the cubicle for my first business being the business I started with. But in hindsight, I knew why I got burnt out 6 months after I launched my first business, which was sort of an agency, a middleman agency in the industry that I left, where I was creating programs for alternative education and schools in China and agents in Taiwan and all this sort of like ESL and adventure, you know, products that I was creating. And I already knew a lot about it. So it felt really natural for me to create a business around. But I didn't really tackle into whether or not I enjoy serving this kind of customer, whether or not I even believe in putting some of those kids in the university programs that I was selling. And that's why I felt burnt out at the end of 6 months or the first 6 months of my business, because I was intentionalizing for this business to get me out of the cubicle and make me money, which it did. But I didn't really focus on which skill sets were really going to be meaningful for me to share and explore. And I would love to encourage you, before you decide on a business idea, is to really start thinking about that, right? Thinking about what sorts of skill sets, your strengths, your deep expertise, what it is that you are willing to make a living from, but also feels purposeful for you to create work around, right? Of course, it should be a high demand skill that people are looking for if you're going to be hired for a service, for example, but it's got to be something that gives you reason to actually start it as well. And then you're going to save yourself months or maybe even years, right, of dissatisfaction of creating just another job for yourself, where you can really start a business based on this deep awareness of yourself. Now, I'm going to be giving you, wherever it's popping up as a little clickable button, is my free training on how to take the leap webinar. And that's going to help you really thinking about your skill sets as well. And I'm also going to give you an additional link for my Create My Dream Business Guide, which is going to help you also take that inventory of skill sets. That's going to help you be clearer about your strengths. What are the things that you want to leave behind? What are skills you want to keep taking forward with you? Just get a little clearer. Now, a lot of us have taken inventory for a long time about our know-how, right? About what it means, you know, in our career, what are the things that we want to take forth with a career that we want to create, right? So if you haven't done that for a little while, you're not clear, you're a bit confused about what it is that you're good at and what it is you can turn into a self-employment career, don't forget to download those freebies that I just recommended. The second mistake I made was not saving enough money in my financial cushion pot. That's what I call it anyway, right? The soft landing, just in case something happens. I didn't really save up enough money, and I think I saved up probably about 3 to 4 months of living expenses in Vancouver. But in hindsight, I probably would have felt better saving up to about 6 to 8 months. Now, granted, I paid off a lot of my debt before I quit my job, so I don't want to give myself too much of a beating here. But if I could give you some advice on, you know, minimalizing your expenses, really taking a stand in, you know, trimming the fat of your expenses and really saving up, like, seriously for the next year for your escape plan, please do that. It's, you know, so much less pressure when you have a good amount of savings behind you to be able to deal with life, right? Our basic survival of paying the rent, feeding ourselves, right? Having a decent life. What I found myself doing when I was always panicked about money because I didn't have as much savings as I wanted, was that I kept taking on clients I didn't want to take, or being really desperate in the way that I was making money, or saying yes to things when I should have been saying no. And that is not a good way to start a business, is it? And so I would love to make sure that you know this, that don't let, first of all, just be realistic that as a new business owner or as a new person who's self-employed, it might take you a little while to start having some traction in gaining stability in your income every single month. So you want to be able to, first of all, try to at least build a business while you're working full-time as a side hustle so you can feel like you've got some foundations in place, you've got maybe a few clients under your belt as you transition. So when you finally quit, you know, you're not completely in the $0 of revenue every month, right? And the secondary thing is that give yourself a bit of leeway, right? Know that maybe the first few months you might be making $1,000, $2,000 a month. It's not quite the full amount that you need. And that's okay because you've saved up enough money, because you've buffered that amount to, right, help you. And because most of the time what we don't think about is the learning curve and the learning time whenever we're new at something, right? So you're not going to be as fast at making money in the beginning of time. You might get scared a little bit to go and pitch to clients. So you want to consider all these factors and lower that pressure for yourself by saving up money ahead of time. And I would now recommend probably about at least 6 to 8 months if you're someone that sort of risk averse that I, like I am at the time, and that would potentially help you to, right, really do this properly and say yes to things that you really want to say yes to and not be desperate and take on clients just for the sake of, or clients you don't like, for the sake of paying the bills. All right, the third mistake that I made was not telling people I'm available for hire in the initial time of my business because I wanted to get everything perfect, like my website to be launched perfectly, my branding and my photos to be all perfect and great. And I really missed out on just actually sharing my intention for my business. Now, this mistake is to do with not the agency business that I had, but Screw the Cubicle. So when I was learning to be a coach, when I was blogging at that time, when I was just sharing my voice, that felt really cool because it was kind of free and I didn't have any pressure about making money just yet. But when people actually started to ask me about services, I was like, oh, I could actually make a living from supporting people less on the freeway, but actually more on a mentorship and guidance level. And so when I started to learn how to coach, I started to really get a hold of what it is that I want to say. I was still really depending on the aesthetics of an online brand, like a website, and my brand, like logo and colors and tagline and the perfect way to say something before I actually told people in my network and my community or even my Facebook page that this was a line of work that was deeply interesting to me now, and I was moving and pivoting my work there. I didn't ask for referrals. I didn't ask people to share the new videos I made. I didn't do any of that thing because I felt, to be honest, a bit like a fraud. But here's the thing. You start somewhere and you grow into your expertise and you are not a fraud because very likely the thing that you are sharing today is really beneficial for someone out there to hear it. When you are one step ahead of somebody else, you are a bit of an expert. So you don't have to know everything. That's what makes you feel like a fraud, that you have to be this expert in mastery, 20 years in the making in order to have permission to share your voice. And that's not true. If you have the interest, the inspiration, a story to tell, a passion to share, you are ready to share that. So I want to encourage you, don't make that mistake I do. Start talking about your interests. Start talking about your work and your business, even if you haven't launched a business yet. Start talking about things you're curious about or knowledge or insights that you want to share without even having a Facebook page or a brand just yet. You are the asset of that information. You are the person that's sharing that. All you need is you. All you need is you. That's not really the song, but it kind of rhymes, right? It kind of goes. So if you have a point of view, if you have a perspective, if you are walking down the street one day and you're like, oh my God, I feel inspired to share this thing or tell people that I can help in this area, even if you don't have your services page up yet, figure out a way to do it. Turn on that Facebook live stream. Turn on the Instagram story stream, whatever your social platform is. Write a blog on medium.com without paying a penny to be hosted there, right? You can do so much to share your voice and tell people you're ready for hire, tell people you're ready to help in the service ahead of time so that when you actually have your brand ready to go, people are really warmed up to the idea that this is the path of work that you're choosing now. Finally, create systems sooner than later. This was a mistake that I had to pay for about a couple years back when I started to build a bigger team. So it's really natural to assume that the only time you create a system, like things like having, you know, standard operating procedures of how things are done, documenting your processes, having checklists, filming screen shares or tutorial videos for someone to replace some of the work that you might be doing. Later on, when you think you get busy or when you're more successful, you'll start doing that. But to be honest, by that time, you'll be too busy and you'll be already too knee deep into all this work to be able to get your head up your own butt to be able to create these systems. And so I had to take on about full time for a whole month just to create systems into place to be able to hire a team of support systems to do the work and repeat the work that I do every single month. And I wish I documented my steps ahead of time. So if you're a new business owner or you're starting a business and you have particular things that you repeat doing every time, whether they're client proposals, onboarding a new client process, blog writing, setting up videos on your YouTube channel, whatever it is that you do recurringly for your business, start documenting your steps ahead of time so that you feel organized for yourself every time you do that task again, but also is setting you up to be confident to give that task to somebody else or outsource that to somebody else and know that you are always prepared for that, right? And sometimes when you do this checklist, you do this process, you start to see that you might do a lot of redundant things or certain tasks can be automated a bit better or a template can be set up to increase efficiency to get something done well. And that's going to result in happier clients, easier things for you to do, and you're not wasting your time starting from scratch every single time. So starting to create systems sooner than later is a huge tip I want to give you today. And don't make that mistake. Start now when things aren't so busy, because that's your future you, when you hire a team, is going to thank you later on. All right. So I hope you enjoyed some of the mistakes that I made and the candid conversation we've had so far about mistakes for self-employment. But I would love to hear from you what mistake or learning from that mistake that you liked most, that you think was most useful for you today, that you would like to start implementing. So comment below this video. Let me know what was sort of valuable and significant for you to make changes on. I would obviously love to hear from you. So again, if you would like additional resources and I want to support you, right, on making sure that you are preparing for self-employment in the most effective and efficient way, don't forget to wherever it's popping up and also the link in the information below this video, there are two giveaways that I'll be giving over to you. The first one is Create My Dream Business Guide, which is going to help you take inventory of your strengths and skills and figure out ways you can deploy them in a meaningful way when it comes to your interests and your impact. And the second giveaway is the Take the Leap webinar, which I outline all the core ingredients you have to prepare for when you take the leap so that you feel really clear about what it is that you want to be getting ready and, you know, making sure that you're preparing before you actually quit your job and know that you're doing this in a safe and practical way so that you can do it faster than, you know, procrastinating around it and also being fearful what to expect. So in that webinar, it's super helpful. I go through everything that is from the money mindset or the financial financial piece that you have to prepare, to the skill sets, and then to sort of how you might want to test out your skills in a side hustle, and what are things that you might need to consider before you quit your job. I think it'll be really helpful for you as someone who might be interested in self-employment. Thank you so very much for joining me, and I'll be back next week for another video. So don't forget to subscribe and hit the notification button to be notified of new videos coming your way. Thank you so much for joining me. Have a great day. Bye.